DNA has unlocked links to thousands of matches. But are you related to all of them? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes. Now that you've tested and checked out your ethnicity results, it's time to take a look at all of those DNA matches. These are the people who have also tested that we share some segment of our DNA with. If you have a small extended family, you may be surprised that you share DNA with so many people. But are you related to all of them? I hate to pull a Bill Clinton here, but it depends on what you mean by related. To begin, the simple answer is yes, because all humans are related. Through DNA, we can actually see that everyone, all humans, are related to Y-DNA Adam and mitochondrial Eve, two individuals who lived at separate times in East Africa about 100,000 to 200,000 years ago. More than 99% of your DNA is the same with everyone else, but that's probably not the answer you're looking for. Saying that somebody is your 5,000th cousin 250 times removed doesn't imply a really close relationship. Next, let's look at a genealogical timescale. This is where there are records that might be able to corroborate a relationship that is suggested by your DNA. Now, this really depends on where you're from. In Europe, where almost all of my lineages can be traced back to, there are records that are reliable back to about 1000 CE. However, the vast majority of those lineages really can only trace our records back to about 1600 CE. So let's use that as our reference point. From 1600 CE to 2000 CE, there are 400 years, which is about 10 to 15 generations. So the question is, are all of our DNA matches related to us in the last 15 generations? The short answer? No. There are a couple of ways that you can have a DNA match with somebody and not be related within the last 15 generations or 400 years. The first one is common population segments. There are certain segments in certain populations that are shared by the majority or the vast majority of members of that population. And so those segments continue to get passed down on and on through the generations. In this case, you may be related to these people, but it's not gonna be in the last 15 generations. And so you're probably not going to be able to corroborate that with any kind of genealogical records. You may be 20 or 30 generations removed from that DNA match. Now, these are usually small segments below 15 centimorgans, but they can be larger, as large as 30 centimorgans in some rare instances. The second way that you can have a DNA match and not be related to somebody is because you have two chromosomes for each pair. That makes sense, but the computer analyzing your DNA data doesn't know that. You could have one chromosome from your father that looks like this, and you could have one chromosome from your mother that looks like this. Now, together, you may match somebody with a chromosome that looks like this. And you can see that it actually doesn't match either one of your chromosomes. What it's doing is it's going through each location and hopping back and forth between the chromosomes. So this is a false match. Now, statistically, somewhere around 7 centimorgans to 10 centimorgans, the number of false matches start to outnumber the number of real matches. That is why you hear from a lot of genetic genealogists to not worry about matches below 7 to 10 centimorgans. Those two categories account for the majority of your matches that are below 20 centimorgans. But what about those matches that share more than 20 centimorgans? Are you related to all of them? The quick answer is yes. It is very likely if you share more than 20 centimorgans, other than the cases that I've already talked about, that you are genetically related to them within the last 15 generations. And so it's possible, depending on the genealogical records, to identify who that specific common ancestor is. Now, if you share 50 centimorgans or more, you are definitely related to that individual within the last 10 generations. So that's only about 300 years. You can check out some of my other videos that talk about how we share DNA with different relationships. And as always, if you have any questions, put it in the comments below and we'll try to answer it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends.